Reuben had a complaint what he referred to as night hoss, and I believe the warm weather was too much for him. We had some lively times. What was the nature of your acquaintance?
We're now in the beginning of the operational, and I've already made a friend of death. I'll never commit suicide. I don't want to die. I love life more than anything. But I'm saying I'm ready to do whatever it takes. I'm not going to back down. I'm not going to give in. Just a spiritual choice.
You know, we've given billions for vaccines and saved millions of lives. No, we're you know, trying to make money for vaccines and, you know, not trying to save lives. That's, you know, a popular conspiracy theory.
A Snicker. Snicker is made to replicate a black man's penis. What is the concept of a hot dog? And why do a hot dog go between buns? What about pizza? How pizza is used for pedophiles. It's called Pizza Gate.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I can feel my balls shrivel just as you tell me this. So,
girls, beautiful girls or any type of girls like bad boys. They like badass. No one likes a gentleman. So while you're bad, you should be a bad boy.
Welcome to War Mode.
Through all these years that are in question, you were a virgin.
That's correct.
Never had sexual intercourse with anyone in high school.
Correct.
And through what years in college, since we're probing into your personal
life
here?
Many years after. I'll leave it at that. Many years after.
I refuse to buy into the leftist division. And I refuse to let them target our children with all the sterilization and transgenderism. And I demand people wake up out of the coma and not give George Soros and the New World Order the race war they want.
You're gay now.
Yeah.
You've become gay.
Why are
you gay?
I'm not a Trumpy. I want you to know that now.
Thanks for your comments and for your love you have shown upon me. Hey, you can leave a comment in my podcast, and I will tell you the process of doing all those lovely stuff. Yeah, enjoy your life. Woohoo!
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
We're good. Good.
Okay. What do you want to talk about? Can we talk about eugenics?
Talk about whatever you want.
Oh, okay. Okay. Can we start over?
No.
Please.
No.
Bill, I'm fighting this thing.
I don't care anymore.
Not starting over.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll wait. Solo cast.
It's all right.
Wow.
So did you see Our Father on Netflix?
No.
Did you see this? Did you hear about this?
No.
I sent it on the group chat. It's fine. If you don't watch it, it's fine. But the dude, the guy was a sperm. He was doing live inseminations back in the 70s with his own junk. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And this went on for a while. This went on for like many years. And they find out, all the siblings found each other out on 23andMe. So, there was that. And then, there was that. And then there was like seven siblings that found each other through 23andMe. And then it grew to like many more. It's like, ended up being like in the 90s, dude. It's nuts. It's still going on today. They're still finding each other. It's pretty crazy. You know? So, I thought that was pretty cool. And then there was... So I was watching Love on the Spectrum, and I really like all the, there's a lot of really good people on Love on the Spectrum, and I just like kind of fucked me up because the United States dude really got really into like state controlled infertilization projects where they would sterilize people, and so that we wouldn't have love on the spectrum. We wouldn't have it today. We wouldn't be able to watch these guys because they thought they were imbeciles. And, you know, there's this guy who's the Supreme Court, and he was like, you know, three generations of imbeciles is enough. So they mandated sterilization in a law in like 38 states. It's fucking nuts, dude. And so that was like in Virginia. They had this thing in Virginia where they used to like think that white guys with brown hair were like not the Nordic race that they were like trying to aspire to. So if they found a white guy just chilling and he had brown hair, they called him a mongrel, the Virginia mongrels, and then they would just go pick them up. They would just go pick them up, and then they'd say, "Hey man, where do you live?" And he's like, "Oh, I live up in the hills up here." And it was like the Whitakers, and they'd roll up and go grab them, and they'd grab them all, and they would put them into these institutions that the Carnegie Foundation funded, and then they would sterilize them all. That was another thing that they did. And all this stuff started with Plato. 2,000 years ago. 2,000 years ago, Plato had a plan where he wanted to like do like a eugenics where they would have the best people get married to the best people. But he knew that the population would never go for it, so he wanted to have like a secret lottery. But really, it would be like, oh, we're doing a marriage lottery. But really, what they were doing was secretly they matched the best people. So there's that. So eugenics means good birth. It comes from Charles Darwin's cousin Dalton, or Galton. Galton actually is the guy that discovered that we all have unique fingerprints, and that's why we have fingerprint evidence today for detectives and things. And a lot of this stuff in our time period started out in Cold Spring Harbor in Long Island, New York. They had breeders' associations and fitter family contests. Is that enough? Good. I have to keep going.
Solo cast. I want to die.
Yeah. You feel better now, though, right?
I feel better. I feel good. Yeah. According to Dylan Goldman, I feel good enough to go out. So, fucking loser. I hate everyone. It upsets me. People listen to this podcast. That's how much I hate these people.
Why?
Huh?
Why do you hate them?
Just the shitty. Dude, you could say whatever the fuck you want. I don't care. But once you start getting shitty. Like a girl, I get so fucking angry. Like, you're a fucking woman. If you're, it's Sunday, you go into the comment section and go, oh, you can go out, but you can't do this, I will fuck you.
How'd they know you went out?
Because I posted a video of you.
Oh, really? Oh, great.
KOI. King Instagram, I'm not even allowed on.
What the fuck, dude? What? Don't take shots at me,
dude,
bro.
I'm sorry.
Definitely don't take shots
at me. Tell them why you're not allowed on Instagram?
Yeah.
Doing that sus shit?
I can't do anything, right?
They're girls. They not ask you. I can't do anything, right?
I put my birth date as like last week, and then they're just like, you're not 13, you can't be on Instagram. So now I'm just I'm just locked out, can't go back on.
Dang.
Now how am I supposed to be cool?
You're doing good, dude.
No, I'm
what are you talking about? You're at the Barstool Bar ripping it
fuck up. That place.
Music was loud. I don't like
the music
noises.
Was loud.
Yeah,
I've never seen anything like you reading that just now.
I mean,
your eyes, dude, you're fucking crazy. Like, he would start, he would say things, dude, you go like this, you're like, and that's eugenics. Like, it's fucking.
I'm just doing it to try to make people laugh.
I was losing my marbles because it's just like you're sitting there all week long doing the deep dive, and it's somehow we get to Plato. Like, just somehow we're like 2,000 years ago, Plato.
I got like 5 pages of this shit, dude. That was like half a page.
Yeah, that was, I mean, we're not even close to done. I could listen to that all day long. I agree with everyone. I think I'm holding you back.
You gotta get out of the comments, dude. You're in the comments, bro.
No. I read everyone. I like.
Yeah, I read everyone.
Especially the fucking homos are like, I know he's reading this. Like, yeah, jerk off. They get emailed to me every fucking time. I see it. It's on my fucking email. I hate you. I'm sorry.
Well, this will help. I'm sure they'll probably stop doing it now.
No, I don't care. Do it all you want. Do it all you want. I can't wait until me and Spade can just enjoy our life and be done with this.
It's almost over, dude. We're getting there.
You guys aren't having fun?
We're having fun. I have fun. I talk to Spade every fucking day.
Yeah.
We have fun every day.
Yeah, but people want to hear it. I want to hear it. You guys are the only... This is the podcast I listen to. This is the only podcast I listen to. I listen to it every time.
Come on, bro.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun to hear how you guys are doing. How the ladies are treating you.
Horrible. I got fucking... Literally
Shane said some chicks that I was hot.
A girl DM'd me and said, tell Spade I'm 22 years old and think he's hot as fuck.
And...
I just found out about it. But he doesn't have Instagram.
How does that make you feel?
Pretty good, pretty good.
I'd say that. Well, just from the picture you put up of me and him.
Are you happy about this?
Yes, yes.
What do you say to her?
Wow.
I would practice. Like, some bud.
Yeah, I mean, that was... Whatever happened last night, I was very weird. That chick just, like, beckoned me over and then walked me downstairs and...
You're a fine piece of meat, dude.
You are a fine piece of meat.
But it was with the whole time, my feelers are up.
You look like a famous country singer when you're in there.
Yeah, you do. You got a presence.
Yeah.
Oh, bro, seriously?
Yeah, especially up in the VIP section.
In the VIP section with that long hair flipping out.
The barstool bar.
Yeah. And that young hot girl came over and said, come with me. Follow me.
But there was something up the whole time.
My divine boy, follow me.
There was like a TikTok dude with her, and like
I
got real weird out because I was sitting there and her friends come up and then they start laughing. I'm like, oh, what the fuck's going on here? And I immediately was like, I'm fucking out of here. I don't want to do this.
Yeah,
because I knew sorcery was afoot.
There was sorcery.
I mean, I've been getting approached by literal witches, bro.
Yeah, I heard.
What the fuck?
Yeah, why are they trying to hex you?
I don't know. It might be the turquoise.
They knew the semen retention.
Yeah, that's over.
They could feel the... Why is that over?
Huh?
What happened?
I got stricken with a night horny. You ever get horny as fuck at night?
Yeah.
You get the wickedest boners, or I had to do it.
When was this?
Dude, your shoes.
Day 96. Day 96.
Bill's wearing fucking women's shoes.
Well, comment about that, guys. Yeah, just make fun
of me. No, I'm sorry. They are actually sick. In fact, I said that to you immediately. I said, those are cool.
Yeah.
You said, check out the shoes. These are the cool shoes. I said, those are cool shoes.
Yeah, I just thought it was, I wanted to get something for the summertime. And I was like, well, I got the beaded seats from the Indians. And then I was like, fucking, they make pretty good slippers. So I got slippers from India.
Mm.
I think they're a bit too small.
Oh, those are from Dr. Boobs.
These are from Dr. Boobs.
Those are the Dr. Boob ones.
You just named him.
Oh, shit. Are we not supposed to?
No, you can't. I want to buy the domain. But we always put him in the intros, and no one knows who the fuck that is.
Oh, no.
No. Dr. Boobs is fine. I want this man to shine.
Trying to juice up Dr. Boobs, man.
Yeah.
He's not getting any money.
So you're doing this, but this podcast is about eugenics?
Well, I mean, I just got into it because of the Our Father dude and watching Love on the Spectrum. I was like, damn, imagine trying to get rid of fucking retards.
Yeah.
They're the best.
Possible.
They're the best.
Yeah.
Well, these guys thought it was possible. That's the thing. And this was like the fake science of the elites back then.
What was the reasoning?
Well, the deal was they wanted to make a better society.
I feel like everyone was illiterate back then, too. Like, how are you figuring out who's retarded?
So, there was a combination of, like, Darwin came out with the theory of evolution.
Yeah.
Still on the fence about that one.
Right.
And then Nietzsche came out and was like, God's dead. We make our own morals. And then out of that, you get progressives. And they were like, we're going to take everything to the future because we're going to grab the reins of human genetics and make us a better society. And their idea was blonde hair, blue eyes, tall, all that, Nordic Chads. Right. And that's what they were fighting for because at the same time this is happening in America, the immigrants are coming over from Poland, southern Italy.
It's kind of gay to be like a eugenics doctor and be like, we need to make all the guys blonde and hot.
Oh, yeah,
like, wait, what?
Yeah, it's fucking wild.
They are. A lot of them,
the perfect guy?
A lot of those dudes are real weird with that shit.
Yeah, and it was like the top academics in Harvard and stuff that were pushing it. So it wasn't like retards that were pushing this stuff.
Yeah.
But the KKK got on it. Margaret Sanger got on it. She said some wild shit about black people, calling them human weeds. Dude, I got a quote from Margaret Sanger.
You gotta really hate black people. Come up with something like that.
Dude.
Human weeds, bro.
She goes, colored people are like human weeds and are to be exterminated. And she said,
what the fuck?
We do not want the world to go out We do not want the word to go out that we want to exterminate the Negro population, and the minister is the man who can straighten out that idea if it ever occurs to any of their more rebellious neighbors, like the black ministers.
And this chick runs Planned Parenthood.
She started Planned Parenthood. And then Bill Gates is...
I like that, liberal.
Yeah, Bill Gates' grandfather was in it for a while.
Yeah, I mean...
He was on the board.
And people...
But they've always been doing this shit, and it's like... They did this, they tried to pull it in America, they tried to do eugenics, but they couldn't do it because when everybody came in Ellis Island, they just like wrote shit down and never organized it, but the Germans were very organized, and yeah. IBM Nordic ran their punch cards, and that's how they started rounding them up, and in Germany, Hitler loved eugenics, and so we did it for like 20 years in America before Hitler. Hitler got it from
us. What
were
we doing?
We were doing it, dude. We had camps, but we didn't call them concentration camps. We called them farms and colonies. Right. And they had like institutions where they would just take dummies, roll them up.
Send them out to the farm.
And send them out to the farm.
You drop
your
kid off at the farm.
It was wild.
Were they killing them?
They were sterilizing them.
Dude, you know Hitler was sterilizing fucking alcoholics too?
Yep. But all this came...
Got hammered. They were going to chemically castrate you.
All this came from this dude, Davenport, in a Cold Spring Harbor. And... like Hitler wrote a note to them. I gotta find the fucking. He wrote them like fan mail.
Love your work.
Oh yeah, dude,
epic
for real.
Shit.
Dude, I gotta find. He goes, "Your book is my Bible." He wrote it to this dude, Madison Grant.
Literally yeah, fangirling like, Madison
dude,
Grant.
So nice. Be like, dude, it's so sick. You guys have them all on a farm, dude. That's I've never so even sick. Thought about oh that. Shit, you guys are doing that for real?
Yeah, like the elites. I feel like that's what I'm saying. Like Plato is doing this stuff. So I think like there's. I think this is like inherent in people.
What, the fucking kill tards?
I think, like, once you're elite for a couple generations, you kind of want to get rid of everybody else.
Yeah,
I think that might be a thing. That just is part of human nature.
Bro, did you see the shit with monkeypox?
Yeah, monkeypox isn't real.
No, what just happened in Europe?
What do you mean?
There was a fucking gay pride thing in Europe, like a parade or whatever, and there was 80,000 people there or some shit, and it's now the epicenter of the monkeypox spread.
Dude, Peter McCullough said it's complete bullshit. This is all to round up money for 13 million vaccinations. This is just another vaccine thing.
What?
Yeah, dude, the pictures that they're showing of these monkeypox kids, they're 30 years old.
Come on.
Peter McCullough's on Jones 2 days ago. debunking the shit out of this, being like, don't let this happen again. I'm telling you, this is the fake science that the elites were doing back in the day, and that's the reason that the Supreme Court was allowed to sterilize people. This guy, Oliver Wendell Holmes,
what are you laughing at?
Dude, this guy, Oliver Wendell Holmes, he was like, he said, we were allowed to vaccinate them. They got forced vaccinations through.
Yeah.
And then after that, they were going to, all right, we can do forced sterilization. History repeats itself, bro.
Well, yeah, why are they trying to do monkeypox? This shit's gay as fuck.
They're just going to keep trying. All these guys have like monkeypox vaccines they make up, but they don't sell because monkeypox isn't a big deal. But they use the media to hype it up. And then if they can create fear, then they can say, all right, well, you're going to need our vaccines. And then the U.S. government just gave them, but just bought 13 million vaccines off of them.
Where'd you get a copybook?
Oh, I got all these from my Uncle Charlie.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
What the fuck, dude? Why does it matter if he has a copybook?
I'm just happy he's writing this in a
fucking
copybook.
Yeah, I got to write all this shit down, dude, yeah.
And then, yeah.
Yeah, they used to call people feeble-minded. So they would have rounded you up. Definitely would have rounded you up.
What? Why?
Irish guys with brown hair, gone. You're going to the colony.
Fuck. I thought you were calling us feeble-minded.
Yeah. You're like, definitely you. I was like, what the fuck?
No, that's what they would do. They would just go, they're feeble-minded. That was like their general thing. And they called them the Virginia, or they have a book called The Mongrel Virginians. It's fucking hilarious.
What's it about?
It's about like all these different families that they monitored, how they were like mongreling themselves and like interacting with Native Americans. There was these dudes that were pushing in the 20s to get Native Americans classified as Negroes so that they could put them in the Negro Project.
Really?
And IBM, before they did the Holocaust, IBM, the same company made these cards. The reason that they could carry it out in Germany was that company made cards to do this thing called the Jamaica Cross, the Jamaica Project or something. And they were the Carnegie Foundation was trying to get rid of black people in the world. They were going to start in Jamaica, yeah.
Damn. I wonder why. Like, this was just like, how the fuck, how do you even see them? Like, how are these dudes even around black people to hate them that much?
I'm telling you, man, they just got, it was like a thing that they were doing for like.
You're not
even have fucking TV
them.
Either. You're not even watching They would, Carnegies would never see them.
Dude, for like,
they must have saw one and just been like, what the fuck?
Dude, for like 40 years.
What the fuck are these guys?
For like 30 or 40 years, everybody was on this in the US, like, except for the immigrants. But all the people that were here during the Civil War, the guys that came out of that afterwards, when the immigrants came, they were like, bro, we got to do something about this. And they got way into eugenics, dude. And they were like, we'll just sterilize them. We won't kill them. We'll sterilize them.
Dude, I mean, it seems like you're doing it right now.
When do you think it stopped?
Never.
The 70s.
Huh?
Yep.
What do you mean it stopped in the 70s?
They stopped doing these sterilizations during Nixon.
When Planned Parenthood started?
No, Planned Parenthood was around way before that.
Okay.
But yeah.
I wonder how vicious abortions were in the 50s.
Dude, they rounded up these two teenage chicks. I got to charge my laptop to be able to show it to you. But the these two chicks, the Ralph chicks, they took a 14 and a 17-year-old girl. They took them to like a Planned Parenthood in the 70s. And using federal money, they sterilized them. They cut them out. They cut their tubes. And their
Jesus
dad,
Christ.
They got home and their dad was like, they thought they were getting IUDs because their older sister had been rounded up and got an IUD.
What?
Yeah, the early days IUDs.
Who's banging?
Well, that's what the thing that they saw these girls. They thought they classified them as feeble-minded. And then they were like, we can't let the boys started hanging out with them. So then they were like, all right, we'll take them over to Planned Parenthood. And then they cut their tubes.
What the fuck?
It was four sterilizations, yeah. And the guy the trial was, I think it's called Ralph versus Weinberger, and that's one of the Bechtel guys.
Really?
He was in the Department of Health and Human Services back in the 70s.
Holy fuck.
It's fucking nuts, bro. Dude. Yeah.
Like, how the fuck did you come across all of this?
This is what I do when I get bored.
God, you're a weapon, bro.
Yeah, I got so much more of this shit, dude.
Dude, there's a place in West Philly. It's past it on our way here. There was do you know the name of the doctor? The abortion boy?
No, but it's why it's like famous.
Dude,
yeah.
He was vicious. Like, he would take a baby out of a chick's pussy and stomp its head in.
Dude, they got a guy.
Dude, swear to God, it's still up there. The building's still there.
Yeah, they keep trying to tear it down.
Wait, what do you mean?
Thrash kids, dude.
He would do abortions and, like, fuck the kid up?
Dude, literally stomp on their head, slam them, like, fucking destroy them. Swear to God.
Yeah, the early days of this, there was a guy that used to call him the Black Stork. And what he would do is, if the baby was born deformed or they thought it was going to be retarded,
I'll take that.
He would take him out of the mother, put it in the little, like, incubation table, never touch it again, never feed it, nothing, just let it die. And they thought it was, like, thumbs up, dude.
Fuck.
Thanks for doing that.
How'd you come up with that?
Yeah. It's fucking nuts, dude.
Jeez.
Damn, that's real sad.
But yeah, the Rockefeller Foundation, or the Rockefeller Foundation funded this shit, and they funded it globally. And, like, there's this guy, Otmar Vashir. He was, like, the head of eugenics, the global eugenics, right? Kind of like a World Economic Forum, WHO type thing, global institution. So Vashir's assistant, his name was Joseph Mengele. And Joseph Mengele was right. So Vashir,
in America.
Vashir was his boss. Mengele was his assistant. Mengele posted his results from all of his tests every week. All the American guys were all over this.
But now, was he in America?
No, he was in Germany doing this, but
okay.
In California, that was like the head base of all this.
Yeah.
Eugenics program. And he would post his studies, and all the American eugenists read it. And after Nuremberg, they made eugenics a crime against humanity.
Yeah.
So then they changed the classification, they changed the name from eugenics to human genetics. And it's still around today. And all those guys, that Vashir guy, never got in trouble. Mengele went down, and everybody knows about Mengele, but
loophole.
Vashir just came back into the arms of the California doctors, and they're like, we'll still keep this going. They've been doing eugenics this whole time.
Dude.
And like every once in a while, it ramps up again. And like right now, it's ramping up with this shit that they're calling nugenics, where they're trying to do designer babies.
Yeah,
trying to do knockouts for bipolar.
What's knockout? Oh, like you just
like
get
so
rid
you
of
don't
it?
Get bipolar. But like, dude, if they did follow eugenics, it's like you don't get bipolar, you don't get shorts, you don't get Kanye West, bro. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Deadpool.
You don't get a lot of cool people.
Yeah, they're really vicious against shorts, though.
Oh yeah. That's like the number one.
That's fucked
nobody
up.
Wants one. Like, nobody would opt for their kid. If you're designing a kid, you're not
you might as well
shirt.
Be a midget.
Yeah.
You're better off as a midget.
The options are like, tall or medium height.
Yeah. I'd rather be, no offense.
Everybody says it. Everybody laughs. It's fine.
No. Like, it sucks to be 5'7" yeah. and people give you the normal treatment.
5'6".
And then like
nah, you're 5'7", bro. I saw you.
You're a fucking Mitch and everyone's like, dude, everything you do is awesome.
Yeah, right.
Meanwhile, we got dudes out here that are just normal height getting fucking sewered by people for no reason.
Let's see what else I got.
I like this, dude.
This is nice. I'm too comfy, dude.
How nice are the Trevors?
Yeah, this is great.
You only talk when you feel compelled to talk.
I don't really have. I got nothing.
No pressure.
Yeah, bro. No cameras. Nice.
Obviously, dude.
I fucks heavy with it.
It's so gay to have cameras, man.
Yeah, I agree.
We can't. But
it helps. People like it. People like on. People like the YouTubes.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, so anyway.
Shut up, dude.
Dude, 64,000 people at the end of the day got sterilized. They used to round them up and put them in mental institutions. And
I don't want to talk about dogs.
In the 1900s, dude, 1900 to 1920, the eugenics, these were their methods that they were proposing in 1900 to 1920.
Yeah.
Gas chambers in America. They would take the colony, they would get round up dudes in a village, walk them into a giant chamber, turn the gas on. Then the Carnegies were like, yo, bro, they're not ready for gas chambers yet. So they backed out of that one.
They were going to put retarded guys on a farm.
No, they would go to a
village. And then one day be like, come on, guys.
They would go to a, dude, they would
mice and men those boys all at once.
They would go to a township and go, give us your fucking village idiots. We'll take them all. We'll put them all in a room, gas them. And the whole township would be like, all right, cool, that was good. You know what I mean?
No one's batting an eye at this.
No, they said that it would not yet. They were like, they're not ready for that yet. That was their 1900 and 1920. Then they went into mental hospitals.
Those places are fucked.
So dude. They sterilized all those guys, but that wasn't enough. Sometimes these guys would get like into killing them, so they would purposely dose them all with TB.
What's that?
Tuberculosis.
Oh, fuck.
And then they would just have entire wings of the mental hospital just die. They would do this on purpose to get rid of these motherfuckers.
Oh, my God. Yeah, dude. Man. Don't you get sad fucking researching this all week?
Yeah, I'm not all week. I mean, just like at night every once in a while.
Nice brag, honestly. This is a lot of shit.
Nah, it's whatever.
What is a mice and men? I never saw that.
Of mice and men?
Yeah.
there's a big idiot. And he...
I feel like people have put that picture up before me in Spade.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
That makes sense. You love them, yeah. But he squeezes, they're like migrant workers, and he squeezes the boss lady's wife to death.
Gives her the squeeze, and then, dude.
Like a hug?
Yeah, she's kind of being a slut and seduces him.
Oh, my God. He just hugs her to death?
Yeah, he squeezes the shit out of her. And then they have to put him down. And his buddy, he's like... The whole time Lenny's asking him about these rabbits, he's like, once we get enough money, we're going to get rabbits and have a farm, right? He's like, yeah, for sure. Takes him to a creek. he's like, tell me about the rabbits. And he's like, all right, I'll tell you about the rabbits. Bullet to the back of the head, bro.
Damn.
That's how war mode ends. That's how it ends, dude.
Shane's like, Spade, you can go anywhere you want, dude. Yeah. I'll take you somewhere.
I'm not going to watch it, but thank you for that.
Read it.
Oh, it's a book?
Steinbeck.
It's a good movie, dude.
Yeah, it is a really good movie.
I'll still watch it.
I should have ruined it for you.
No, it's okay.
Yeah, but yeah, it's like a pretty big reference.
Yeah.
It's a good one.
I get it all the time.
Yeah.
And I just nod my head and, yeah.
That's exactly what Lenny would do.
Yeah.
Except he might get you.
He might hug you to death. Yeah, dude, that fucking place I ate at last night was wild.
Yeah, what, you said you ate a baby crab?
Hiroki. Yeah, I like, suppose.
Yeah, I got that text. I didn't, what, you ate a live crab?
No. There's this place called Hiroki, and supposedly it's hard as fuck to get into. And me, Cookie, who you met last night, my cousin Pat and his wife, Ray was like, I want sushi. I was like, all right, well, I'll try this place. I know this is sushi. But fuck, bro. It's like, we somehow got in, and the first thing is a fucking wooden box of like little like squares of different shit. The first thing was like an egg that was cooked in cold shit. So you fucking ate the egg and then shot it. And mind you, I'm a picky boy when it comes to eating. This was the most insane shit I've ever ate in my life. Hold on. After that, you just kept going over duck, which was good as fuck. And then top right, there was snapper sashimi. But on top of it, it was a wee crab, dude. It was like the size of a half dollar. And I was like, what am I meant to do with this? Like, this is just a fucking crab, bro. She's like, you eat it. Like, what do you mean you eat it? And mind you, like, this is like the IQ level of the table.
Like, it's shell. It's a full crab.
It just
crab.
Looks like a
this
crab.
This place is so fancy. And it's me, Pat, and Ray. And you met Ray last
Ray's
night.
Ray's a fucking
out
animal.
Of his mind, dude.
Yeah.
It's probably how you got in. They take a look at Ray and they're like, dude, this guy, we can't have this dude.
We walked in at first, like, and they're like, oh no, you can't come in.
Yeah.
Like, you're not, there's only like five or six tables in there. Like, they're just like, we'll let you know when you're allowed in here.
That's nuts.
Okay.
Did you see the venue? Or did you see the restaurant?
No, I don't know.
It's got a nice hobbit door. It's got a,
it's a circular door.
Fuck circular fucking dude. Hobbit door. You would enjoy that.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, and then like, dude, it was just like,
oh yeah, I guess I would enjoy that.
Beautiful.
Sure.
Yeah, the fucking
the fellowship.
Everything that I ate, jellyfish, fucking tastes like exactly what I think jellyfish would taste like.
Yeah, right.
What's that?
I used to bite them. I used to bite them, like,
you know what I mean, right?
I used to show off and bite them.
You
lick
a battery? You did?
Yeah, when I was a kid, I'd grab them, bite them.
You like it?
No, they're gross.
Jellyfish?
Yeah, just to fuck with my sister.
The
in the like a live
little clear boys?
Yeah, like the little clear boy, the sand dollar ones. You know, the little
the clear ones.
You would
the little circle boys. Just pick it up, bite it. My dad used to walk down the beach, grab clams, open them up, and rip them.
What a mongrel, bro.
Yeah.
He may be.
I can't wait to
get
give
you guys
a
on a farm, dude. You should have been on the farm.
We all would have. That's what I'm trying to say. We all would have been on the farm.
That's no fun.
Yeah.
Boy.
No.
That's sad.
Not good.
I don't like that.
Yeah, but like, dude, they were the fucking this. It was all like sashimi, and everything was just amazing. Like anything they put in front of me, sea urchin, scallops, all this stuff. You're talking the guy who's been eating steak and rice for the past fucking 3 weeks.
And you didn't get sick or anything.
Sick.
I'm saying, like, it didn't upset your stomach.
It was divine.
My boy.
That was divine dining. Ooh, yeah.
How were you behaving in there? Were you acting correct? Or were you guys, because I know Ray's a big, he was a goofball.
Yeah, we were joking around, but the waiter and the waitress that was serving us were very happy because everyone in there is real fucking tightwad pussies.
Oh, okay.
So we were just having fun.
Nice.
And they were like, we really appreciate you guys coming in. Absolutely.
Did you see any girls while you were there?
No, what, there was older couples there, nothing like crazy. Why?
I'm just asking. I want to know about how things are going with the girls,
horrible,
with the ladies.
Horrible.
How about you?
Well, I don't know, man. I mean, like, we went out last night. I don't think that's really my scene.
No, that's
no one's scene.
Matt was like, dude, what, like, fucking, how are you going to get pussy? I'm like, dude, I don't think this is my
that's not how you
not,
ever
that's
get
not
pussy.
My venue, dude.
You have to be a cokehead, and you have to be in
I couldn't
fucking
hear anything. I was trying to talk to O'Connor, and I could not hear anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's but, I had a feeling that wasn't going to be the best vibe for this for the group, but it was fun. I had a lot of fun dancing.
Oh, yeah.
Acting like a fool, kicking that couple out.
That was crazy that you did that.
I feel bad about it today.
Did you know that?
No, when I saw it happen, I thought that they
the
I thought they were getting kicked out.
It was going to be funny.
You went mad with power.
So I got some power.
You're a mad king.
And no, what happened, I just wanted them to leave our I was like, Matt,
watch
this.
How did they come in, though?
They were in the VIP. They were fine.
Party eugenics, dude.
Dude, they were totally fine. They had wristbands. They were normal people. I told our waitress, I said, could you please get them out of our section? And I walked over to Matt, and I was like, watch this shit. I thought she was just going to make them move out of the section. They fucking spazzed on these people. They, like, flashlighted in the girl's face and, like, grabbed the dude and threw them out.
You just ruined someone's life and caused a fight.
That's what I'm saying. I wonder if Andrew Carnegie was laughing like this when they were sterilizing people.
I told Spade downstairs. I was like, I feel bad about this. Yeah. That was fucked up. But at the time,
you have karma. That like you made a fight.
It was very funny.
Good share.
It was very funny.
yeah,
and also hilarious. It's like you're getting kicked out of that club.
Yeah,
you don't need to be in there. It's not like I kicked them out of like a nice restaurant. It was like a loud DJing. Yeah. You know.
Yeah, that was very loud.
It was fun to watch. It was fun to watch.
Your power.
The power, yeah.
What is that like?
Say, I've never done that in my life.
No. I know that, but I'm just saying, like, when you guys first started the podcast, you were just absolute pissants, right?
Yeah.
And now you're kicking someone out of Barstool. What is that rise? What does that feel like?
That was a lot of fun.
I
had
I know
a lot
that.
Of fun last night. I ended up having a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Boy, let me tell you, when I kicked out that couple, that was a hoot. Well, you guys, to go back to eugenics. I don't want people to think I'm a jerk.
No.
Because that was a jerk move.
Beautiful.
But it was beautiful. It was very fun because this dude had like long hair and they were like both attractive people.
Yeah, everybody was very hot there.
It was very fun to say, please get them out of our section. And then they ripped, didn't they rip the wristband off?
They ripped the wristband off the chick. And she was like, this is fucking ridiculous. And she stormed out. Dude, she started marching out. And then the dude was like, can I still stay for a second? Like, the dude was like, come on, I'm gonna stick around. And Matt started laughing at him. And then they flashlighted him. And they flashlighted him out of the bar.
Holy fuck.
Well, they thought they did something wrong. The staff, obviously.
They bothered
but
you.
But all I said was, could you get them out of our section?
And then you, but it made you even happier that they got
when
kicked
I saw
out
him
the
start to get
bar.
Kicked. Well, no, then I started feeling pretty bad. But it was also like, oh shit!
Yeah, you couldn't like, close that lid after it was open.
No,
dude, you're a real bully.
I'm a bully.
What else happened?
What? What are you doing?
Nothing. Go back. Go back. I'm just enjoying the pot, dude. I might be the worst guest of all time, right?
It's okay.
No, yeah.
I apologize.
We're just chilling, bro.
I had a long night of partying, and you know, we get up here. Sit in these nice chairs.
It just
they
makes
are not good
relax.
For podcasting. Like no. When we did it in your guys' gamer chairs, it was like all about business and we'd get real into it. I'm so chill here. I just like don't even want to do anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really don't want
these to. These might have been a mistake.
No, they're it's the perfect thing because we have to redo what podcasting is. You can't have like, oh, we have, it's just like, if we want to sit here and not say anything for like 2 minutes, whatever.
Yeah. I like it.
Just everyone who's listening, just along for the ride. This is what you want. You're mad that we didn't do one last week. This is what you want. Now you get it. Now you get the guys talking.
Bill was legitimately fucked up.
I was destroyed.
Yeah.
Why?
I was fucked. I don't know.
Oh, you were sick.
He was
yeah,
sick.
He was still sick.
He was trying to play it off like it was allergies. He rolled up to change a tire. Thank you, by the way, for that.
Spade blows his
tire.
I mean, these people
dude.
In the comments, they're so stupid. Spade blows a tire out, dude. I'm sick as a dog. Oh, I couldn't podcast. I'm sorry, my friend. Blew his tire out, jack up the truck, take it off. Mind you, I'm not blue collar. Jacks up the truck, take the wheel off, bring it up to Conshohocken, get a new wheel put on it, put it back on, Spade can go about the rest of his day while he was working.
I worked the whole time.
You do stuff without complaining, which is pretty impressive. Like when you forgot your laptop and had to go back, I would have been a big pussy about that.
No, I think me and Bill are a good team. We're a good work team.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
No complaints here.
No. You guys quietly work. And it's pretty sick. I never saw your setup. This is the first time I've been to your house. And
it's not that bad. I mean, it was bad.
I walked in, TV's on the floor
with
giant fucking closed captions. He's just watching Revenge of the Sith.
I mean, that is retarded.
With a copy book. Eugenics research.
He has a TV mount. It's like,
why is it on the floor?
We got it for him.
I'm just.
Remember, we got it for him for Christmas. The TV mount was a part of it.
You guys got to understand. Once you guys got me that TV and that thing turned on, I haven't done a thing. I get home, and I hit on that dude, and I'm in the tube the whole time. I'm trying to read books. I got this thing called the C.S. Lewis Space Trilogy. It's supposed to be as good as Lord of the Rings.
What?
But like, yeah, it's supposed to be like somehow about Tolkien, but the guy that did Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe wrote it. And it's supposed to be really good.
Is it old or no?
It's old. Yeah.
Damn.
But like, I'm supposed to read it. It's like this big. Come home, Revenge of the Sith again.
Yeah. How long did you go without the tube?
Sick lightsaber battle.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, it's enjoyable.
I'm getting ready for Kenobi. I mean, I know everybody makes fun of me for liking that stuff, but
do you like Star Wars?
Yeah.
Dude, you know that guy? You know that Indian dude that got all jacked for?
I like water creatures.
Oh yeah, his monology or whatever.
You know the guy that got all jacked for the Eternals? He's also in the Kenobi thing. The guy's
really?
Getting paid.
Yeah, he is. He was just a low life
New
Silicon York
Valley.
Comedian.
Yeah.
Was he really?
Yeah.
Damn, and now he's fucking jacked as fuck.
Now he took some gear and literally he's a Marvel superhero.
Had to have taken steroids.
This dude is online trying to say that the Northman was zero gear, all natty, chicken and broccoli and rice. Bullshit. That guy's 45 years old.
Ew, Skarsgård.
Skarsgård's 45.
He was juiced.
There's something going on.
I saw that with my lady, and I was mad.
Why?
Yeah, because
of how fucking attractive that hunk is.
That's a horrible thing to do. Yeah.
Was she?
Why would you watch that?
Excited?
What?
Was she?
Was my girlfriend
excited after watching it?
She's Norse. Yes.
Yes.
She felt proud.
Yeah,
she was proud.
You have yourself a Valkyrie.
I do. But it was also
from the Birch Forest.
Yeah, I don't like those. And people think Vikings are cool.
They are.
They suck, dude.
Nah, they're pretty cool.
Those dudes fucking sucked. Everybody in the Northmen was a fucking dildo.
Nah.
They really sucked.
I mean, you're literally just scorned right now.
It's not what I saw.
I was, when they broke in.
I was amped the whole time. I also it was watched cool. it by myself.
So. It was cool to watch. They ate mushrooms. But those dudes sucked.
Dude, literally, you're going to be like this?
That guy wasn't even that cool.
Okay.
He was rowing his boat. I will avenge you, father. I will save you, mother.
It was pretty neat.
I watched that at 10 o'clock.
When he fucking caught the spear and launched it back.
The beginning scene when they all roll up in the wolves, that was tight.
I wanted the whole movie to be like that. I wanted more of that.
Yeah. It was a little long.
It was long, but I did like chopping up those people.
Yeah, that beginning scene was fucking wild, dude.
I agree.
When he jumped and got that guy on the horse, that was nice. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert, he's going to jump and get a guy on a horse.
I watched it at 10 o'clock in the morning eating steak and rice.
Watched the whole thing?
Almost the whole thing. And I had to rewatch it again.
I saw it in theater.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn, I never go to movies.
Movies are so fun to go to, dude.
Yeah.
When did you see it in theater?
Some of Shane's likes are going to the movies.
4K movies.
Dislikes.
Yeah, that's Skunks. What they were all shooting. All those eugenics guys were shooting for Skarsgård. That's like the deal.
Damn.
Yeah.
Yeah, if we could all be Skarsgård, that would be pretty tight.
Yeah. They also used to think like poverty, promiscuousness, all these things were gene. Once they found out about genes, they were like, oh, there's got to be a gene for that. So it's like you weren't born poor. Poor was born into you.
Damn.
That was their vibe. So they were just trying to get rid of all the losers. And they kept thinking, like, if they did it for three generations, it was just three generations, and then they'll be done.
It's funny to blame, like, to be rich and blame poor people and be like, once we get rid of all the poor people, everybody will be rich.
Yes.
It's like, dude, what do you know? There's going to be poor people again. Yes. There's always going to be poor people.
That must be crazy if they thought they stomped it out and you just see one fucking retard walking down the street just looking all confused. Yeah. Like, fuck.
Dude, I got onto the New York Times, the failing New York Times archives, and you can go back to like the 1900s. We've seen some of these old articles, and it's crazy how retarded they were in like 1907.
Yeah.
Like the art, like you read the newspaper, you're like, God, this is the fucking New York Times. Like these guys are retarded.
Yeah, that's what I don't understand, how like these dudes were doing eugenics on fuckers, because like everyone couldn't read. People were dumb as fuck.
Yeah. Well, dude, it's weird too. Like the way I imagined everything.
Dude, they probably got them.
The way I imagined everything was like the Civil War happened, the South was racist, everybody was white and all this shit. It's like, dude, Mississippi had a black senator in 1870.
Really?
It was right when it was when the immigrants started to come in. That's when all these elites up north got activated, where they're like, yo, this is not cool. And they were like, we got to end all this shit. Because they thought like the race mixing, they were talking about race integrity. And they were like, we're terrified of race mixing.
Why?
Dude, I don't know. This is like their shit was in, they were obsessed with genes, dude. They wanted Northmans.
That's funny.
All they wanted was Nordic Chads.
They definitely got a lot of them, dude.
What do you mean?
Like just thinking about trying to find them. Imagine how mega you had to be if you were getting caught for being a retard back in like the 1700s. Like, dude, it had to be mega.
This one guy was telling a story about how like
you probably couldn't even walk.
Dude, you could just be fishing. You could just be a random dude looking like you fishing, and they'd roll up on you and start asking you questions. And if you didn't know stuff, like they would give you like a real quick IQ test. They'd be like, "Do you know
the ultimate Jimmy Kimmel fucking sidewalk question?"
And they'd be like, "Oh, yeah,
who's the vice president?" He's like, they're like, "Why are you getting the fucking van, buddy?"
If you didn't know, they'd be like, "Ah, he's feeble-minded. Chuck him in here." And then they would go. They'd ask you, "Yo, where do you live?" And they'd go round up your whole family. And then they take your whole family to one of these colonies.
Just because you were a fucking dumbass.
Yep. They take your whole family.
Dude, I'm just not well versed in that.
And then they would sterilize them. And then that would end the line.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Bro. That's what I'm just like.
How prevalent was this?
In 38 states, Virginia was really bad at it. And it ended up.
Good at it or bad with
like,
it?
Like good at doing this.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. North Carolina too. Yeah.
God. Really?
Yeah.
Didn't really work. Those two states are still kind of fucking dumb as shit.
North Carolina had a law that said if you had an IQ of 70 or lower, your balls are getting snipped.
Really?
Yep.
Oh my God, bro.
Yeah.
Damn. That must have been
terrifying.
That must have
been such a fucking stressful test.
Bro, you're just getting a C.
Sweating. Getting a 71.
What's the easiest way to solve this puzzle?
Yeah.
You know the beginning of Tommy Boy when he's reading the fucking names?
Yes,
he's like, yes, dude, I fucking did it.
Turby. Yeah, they had this thing called, the chick that the main thing of this was Buck versus Bell. That's like the main trial.
I'm guessing Buck was the dumbass.
Buck was the dumbass girl. So this chick was...
I'm guessing Buck was the moron.
It was three generations. So it was a grandmother, a grandmother, a daughter. The daughter was promiscuous, and then she had a baby. And then when she had the baby, she was like, we have to sterilize all three of these generations to end it. And that was a fake. It was a fake story. It was a fraud trial, and it went all the way to the Supreme Court, and then they upheld it. And it's never been overturned today.
I mean, dude, yes, this is very bad, but like when you come across the Whitakers on Soulfire on their belly, you're probably just mean, this isn't great, obviously.
What, the Whitakers?
Yeah.
Yeah, lock, I mean, close that door and throw a torch on the roof, dude.
Hell yeah.
get that thing off the fucking earth.
I think
the Whitakers are having fun.
They're having a blast.
So let them go.
Good ass time.
They're getting paid. Now they're getting money.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, these guys are probably rolling around. Like,
back then, if you're on a horse going through fucking Appalachia, if you run into that setup, the Whitakers, you're like, hey, how's it going? And then you go back to the tavern and be like, we got to round these fucking dudes up.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Like, major hazard.
But there was like,
there may have been a bunch of them.
But,
like,
yeah, I think so.
We got to get rid of these fucking
I think everything in Appalachia, I think it was all Whitakers, dude.
Really?
Dude, holy fuck. That's why I get freaked out when like Appalachia gets targeted by the Sacklers, because all those guys are all this corporate philanthropy. That's true. What they got into is eugenics, and like they're into it today. But like I was saying, they're into the positive stuff now, where they're like doing genetic engineering on kids, and that's gonna end up like that movie Gattaca.
What's Gattaca?
Gattaca is where there's like people that are genetically engineered and people that aren't, and if you're natural, you're like a second class citizen.
Damn,
dude. Yeah. Speaking of the Sacklers, I've been staying in Kensington.
Yeah.
I've been driving up and down that, dude.
Yeah.
Holy
K&A's
fuck.
Fuck, dude.
Holy fuck.
I don't travel much, but is there anywhere that you've seen in the country that's like
I've
that?
I've never seen anything like
it's
it.
Fucking wild.
It's
dude.
The worst place I've ever seen in other countries.
Billy has a video of a fucking SUV exploding down there. Oh, it's nuts.
Crazy. It was on K&A. This SUV came in at 100 miles per hour, and K&A's like a huge fucking subway stop.
Yeah.
It rocked the fucking, because you got it, it's the L, so you got to go up like above the ground. It rocked the building and sent a fucking crack from the bottom to the top. But there was a junkie just like fucking
around. This junkie's got no idea what's going on.
Gets leveled, maybe shot 50 feet in the other direction. I think the two people, bro,
it's all on video.
I think the two people got decapitated and dead. It hit the wall so hard, it bursted in flames. Like, it was so hard of a hit that it just bursted into
just being a junkie standing there in a car going 100 miles an hour.
I think he
lives. Bro, he lives. He lives.
He was in critical condition. I swear to God.
Dude, he lives.
He was in critical condition. I'm almost positive he fucking...
He was in critical before.
Oh, yeah.
He just is in critical condition, dude, at all times.
He was bent in half when the SUV came.
I thought about it. I actually took this drive because my cousin lives in Point Richmond, and I was just, like, sitting there staring, like, that must feel so good if you're willing to do that.
Heroin?
Yes.
Yeah.
It must feel awesome.
I think, although what I've been told is at first it does, and then after that you're just trying not to be sick.
You
just
got to
keep doing it. I mean, I'm sure it feels great because you feel sick all day and then you just get to fucking sleep. But other than that, dude, like, and the way they sleep, like, I've been driving around the last 2 days.
Imagine sleeping face down on a sidewalk with piss on.
Like, not laying. They don't lay. They, like, fall straight down, like, curled up in, like, with your arm behind you. It's the saddest thing I've ever seen. Somebody should try to fix it.
Nah.
No,
they give out. They actually millions. They go the other way. They give out needles.
Yeah,
and like there's a park down there called McPherson Square.
Crazy,
and
man.
There's like hundreds of them. So imagine like they hand them out. It's like fresh needles, and they all swarm to it, and they get their needles, and then they all come back to the park, and they set up on the benches to shoot up out in the open. And you see a lot of like newcomers, like a lot of like dudes that look like they're from the Pacific Northwest with their girlfriends, and they're just being junkies
in
Philadelphia. It's fucking wild. They have like nice clothes. They're like nice, like white kids in nice clothes.
Supposedly that isn't
even
bad.
It's the scariest park. Like, it's so at night. Yeah.
What's that movie where? Oh, it was like in like zombie movies where you're walking around like the zombies are fucking like out because like there's no fucking light on them or whatever. It's like walking by all those fuckers just waiting for them to get activated.
Yeah, like 28 days later.
No, I Am Legend.
I Am Legend.
Yeah, it goes in that room and they're just standing. Yeah, they're. It's It's really fucked up.
Supposedly, like, that's like Candyland compared to this like train track they all chill at. Like, in that area, there's a train track, like a like an Amtrak, big line, and they're just down there killing each other. It's like the pits in Spartica. It's fucking crazy.
They had a book a long time ago about this New York City subway system was like that. They call it the Mole People. So there's like formerly used tunnels that are shut down.
Uh-huh.
But the homeless started like posting up, and they have like a whole city that's their own little city down there. And they were killing each other and all kinds of shit. Nothing ever gets investigated.
That's fucking wild. Terrifying.
Yeah, it's like a whole other world.
I couldn't imagine just doing a stint.
That's Agartha, bro.
What, just doing a stint? Like
imagine, like, obviously heroin addicts exist, but like just imagine the reality of you're there and it's like 5 years and then like you blink and then you're just like, I gotta stop.
Yeah.
Like that must be the most insane feeling in the world.
If getting out of that must be so wild.
Like, you know, like on mushrooms where you have all those like flashes and stuff.
Yeah.
And you get like flashbacks and like it's just you for fucking 5 years getting obliterated, like probably doing gay shit.
Getting raped.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Getting constantly like stabbed a bunch of times.
Yeah.
Just stealing everything.
Getting kicked. Yeah. Dude. Those dudes must get kicked.
Infections.
Fucking every other day somebody must kick one of those dudes.
Easily. like every day of your life, dudes are going in your pockets. Yeah. Like you're I wake up like, man, I had a shitty night's sleep.
Yeah.
It's like every night someone's ruffling in your pants to get shit out of it.
Dude, I was working on a house down there where a girl, the one, so I was working on an empty house and the walls were paper thin. I could hear everything. Yeah. This girl was locked in her room getting the shit kicked out of her all day. She was really little. And then there was another girl they were sending her out to go work. And it was fucking insane, dude. It was like, so they were like prostituting their one daughter and the other one's not allowed out of her room all day.
So you see how they get to eugenics, though?
Yes.
It's like, let's go down K&A, say, boys, we got a farm for you.
Yep.
Lights out.
I mean, dude.
That's how, and then we can be like, all right, that problem is solved.
Yeah, they just get carried away.
For right now.
Yeah, I just don't think that, you know, I think it's one of those things where if you get rich and you're an elite for long enough, you just start having these parties, you go to parties and you're like, yeah, man, I think we could do it this time. I think maybe we could do it. We could spin it like this. You push it out there through this, you know?
Yeah, you're just sacrificing a child on the table to lean over a guy at time. Like, I'm going to talk to you afterwards about
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had a fucking good idea. This one's going to work.
If they did forced vaccinations for the public good, they could do forced sterilization and rounding everybody up.
Cucks would do it.
That was their mindset back in the 20s.
I wish I had a fucking kid, bro.
That's the funny shit, too. It was the fucking libs back then, too.
The libs were doing it back then?
It was the progressive Dems, dude.
Liberal.
Actually,
who are you calling a liberal?
Huh?
Actually, who are you calling a liberal?
The libs.
All right.
I'm just calling
dude,
out.
Dude, Margaret Sanger wasn't liberal. Like the only progressive, though. Teddy Roosevelt was into this. FDR was into this. What's the other guy's name? Harding? He was into this?
Good fucking
They were all great. Into eugenics, dude.
You know about the presidents?
I do. You want me to name him?
You just did a pop. What the fuck was that like?
What? Sitting with the Lou dog?
Yeah.
Just another day, bro.
Damn.
I was so fucking horny in that thing.
Were you actually?
Yeah.
All right, back to eugenics.
Guys, keep doing the podcast.
Connecticut had this.
I'm taking a fucking nap.
Dude,
bro.
Connecticut had this thing that they were doing for a while where they were going to just have all the Connecticut heads. So if you came in from somewhere else and they thought you're feeble-minded.
It's like Israel.
They would be like, yo, we're not going to kill you. We're not going to sterilize you, but we're sending you back to Kentucky. And there was a whole thing where it was
just
like
a state full of O'Connors, just a bunch of O'Connors like, you cannot be here.
They had
get what? Out of here. What?
Kentucky?
Yeah, and if they couldn't like figure out where they were from or whatever, they would send them to these farms. They would make these like giant farm colonies, and they had them in Massachusetts and New Jersey. So they would just ship them there. Imagine like rolling in on one of those camps, dude. Everyone there's told they're a retard.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a place. I was driving in Exton a little while.
Like you just end up in a camp. You're like, why are we here? Guys, yeah. Why are we here? Tell me, are you there? Why are we here?
Couldn't be bothered probably either.
That is bullshit rounding those dudes up. Like rounding up fucking Steve.
Yep.
Just a bunch of Steves in there like, wow.
Nice gloves.
I don't really like this. This lonely business isn't for me. I'm lonely.
Yeah.
Dude, they are mischievous fuckers. Yeah. I go to Wally, like, you ever see the tarred line in Wawa where it's like this random fat black chick who takes care of them? They're in Wawa.
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Whoa, dude.
Which Wawa are you talking about?
In general, there's always just a random black chick who's in charge, like, four, like, bad ones.
Oh, I just have cops at mine.
You need to work on how you talk about people with disabilities.
Dude, I'm not saying.
Are you talking about for the employees or customers?
No. They're just in their custom. Like, they drive around to, like, a little handicapped van.
I don't know what you're talking about, dude.
They have, like, aides that, like, take them around during the day.
Oh, whoa. I know what you're talking. Okay, yeah.
Dude, sometimes they get in a while, they fucking start shit.
They do.
They fucking do. I mean, yeah. I don't give a fuck.
Look, I get it.
I'm low on the totem pole.
When I'm standing there and I see a fucking Sizzly just up right by the register, it takes a lot of impulse to not, or to, you know.
Yeah, you have a
Sizzly.
It
takes a lot of to stop that.
You have a Sizzly bear.
If I was one of those bros, I'm munching that.
You do whatever you want.
Every single time.
It's kind of fucking. Must be real comforting freedom.
They gobble glizzies, dude.
They eat hot dogs like
they go in there and grab hot dogs like hot it's dogs. Nothing, dude. All beef.
Yeah, they do fucking. They do that like. They got, I mean, dude, it's fucked up, but it's just a fact. They got like fucking spit coming down off their mouth, and they're hanging over the bakery section. It's like, bro, like, come on.
I mean, it's all part of the white man's control too, because those Snickers bars are fucking, you know, those, they got veins, dude. Lord. Supposed to imitate the big black cocks, dude, mm-hmm. with the caramel inside. Bridge. Why do they have glizzies, dude? Why do they go in buns?
They want you to eat hot dogs.
They want you to eat hot dogs. They want you to be impotent, dude. They want to get you on weed.
Spade was listening to Black Excellence podcast.
Fuck yes.
This is what the culture's talking about.
Yeah, I'd like to know what you guys are on these days. Because it was, like, you guys were on cue. You were on semen retention. Now.
Right now, I just found about, it's called Earn Your Leisure. And it's all about black excellence and how they've been held down. You know, and they're very, very subtly racist. And it bothers, yeah, it bothers like, me. Like, yeah,
how racist they are against white people.
Very racist against white people. And I'm like, this makes me have a bad feeling.
Yeah.
And then I go, I shouldn't do this to people too.
It's
that's nice.
Yeah.
It's next level racism where it's not just like, you're just like, ah, oh, motherfucker. And like, you get pissed. Like, these guys are just like, I saw an Anglo-Saxon white man. Didn't really speak to me. It's like,
yeah.
Chill.
It's like we can't really get like the vibe of God or like spirituality because we don't have melanin.
I heard that.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's like a big part of it. The melanated brothers, they're just like ascended above us.
I do.
They
really
built the pyramids, the land of Chem. Chem means black. All this stuff.
I do fuck heavy with fucking black Israelites. Like as far like the actual like
I have a YouTube.
The
hole.
Mythology of it fucking rules.
What do you mean?
Like the lost tribes.
The wild shit about
the dudes
all this.
From Israel ended up in fucking
yeah, the true Israelites.
The black, yeah,
really? the wild thing.
They just anytime I walk by, they just look at me and go, you "fucking faggot." I'm like, okay, dude, like what the fuck?
It's the lost tribe, dude. They got God punished them and sent them away.
So they just
and now they
there
came
and
to America to
on the
call
fucking
white
sheet.
People faggots.
Dude, the wild thing about it is
he works in mysterious ways.
Yeah.
Millions of views and the comments are insane. So they call it like high level conversations. And dude, I swear to God, it's just like listening to me and Bill.
Yeah.
But it's like millions of views and it's like all the comments are like, I feel so black and smart right now listening to this. And I'm like, dude, this is not good, guys.
Yeah.
We got to stop this.
It is crazy that the fucking black Israelites go on like they do. And like Westboro Baptist Church fucking rolls the temple and starts spewing all that hate. And everyone's like, oh, fuck off. And you go by Sept and there's all those little cunts in fucking temple going to fucking med school, like walking by like, oh, yeah. It's like, you faggot. Like, oh, yeah. You know, that's their culture. Yeah.
They just dress up like pharaohs and call us fucking gay. It's like, what?
I love the Louis Theroux thing on it.
What?
Louis Theroux goes and interviews
oh,
him.
Yes. That's fucking incredible.
That's a good one, yeah.
Yeah, have you ever seen that?
No.
He goes into a black Israelite temple and asks about who's white throughout history and who's black.
It's great,
William
dude.
Shakespeare? Black.
Beethoven?
Black. Definitely black.
Yeah.
It's all about rhythm, honestly.
And then who was the last one? It wasn't Barry Manilow. I think it might have been.
I can't remember.
It was like a singer that was. It might have been Barry Manilow. And they're like, you're not going to believe me on this. Barry Manilow? Black. Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, this shit kills me, dude.
Yeah, it's funny for them too because they believe it.
Yeah,
so they think God sent them on a mission to go down to Temple's campus and call people fucking gay.
Yeah, they're going to
be like, your girlfriend is a slut,
dude. They the funniest shit like we were in Fort Myers after Fed's wedding. And we're just chilling and like, dude, everyone's having a great time. The Fort Myers boardwalk's crazy. Ever been there?
No.
Fucking sick, bro. It's It's like Wildwood on steroids. And these people are fucking, this band is just jamming. And everyone's dancing.
Nirvana.
Eating ice cream. Like, everyone's just having a great fucking time. And then three fucking dudes, just three white dudes with a megaphone walk through just like, you need to repent now in order to save your life. And just, dude, while the band's playing, and people are just like, come on, man. Like, what the fuck? And like, they get by. They're all just sitting at the stop sign waiting across the street just looking at each other. And they just continue all the normal conversation.
We could do that.
What do you mean?
That'd be fun.
What?
You could just go to a campus and hold a sign.
Steven Crowder does it.
Yeah.
True.
Changed my mind.
No, I mean, just go down and be a preacher.
Yeah.
You could do that. You could, if you had just time off while you're chilling, just be like, oh, shit, I'm going to go do that.
Go down to the bell tower.
Walk down, get a fucking megaphone, just start calling people.
I don't think you guys are living right. Hey, I've been thinking about it. I don't really think the stuff you're doing to each other is good.
Now, I don't know exactly what you're doing, but I've been watching a lot of TV lately. And I feel like you guys are probably like those characters. So cut it out.
Yeah, there was a lot of that. When I was at Temple, there was a fuckload of that shit happening.
Yeah, there was a dude always at Drexel when we lived over there.
What was,
always a dude.
Was his racket?
He was just being Christian. And then he drilled me once. He was good.
He got you?
Yeah, he saw me wearing a Notre Dame polo. He was like, by the way, Notre Dame sucks. And I was like, holy shit, dude.
Oh, he was mean?
How are you that good?
I'll tell you one thing about eugenics. Notre Dame
and
the Catholics,
talk about dogs.
They were one of the main people trying to stop it.
Yeah, Catholics, Notre Dame rules.
Notre Dame and the Catholics were like, dude, you got to knock this shit
off. Notre Dame
also
beat the fuck out of the KKK. You ever hear that?
No, how they do this?
There's a whole book on it. The KKK was big in Indiana. And they hated Catholics.
South
yeah,
Bay.
Yeah.
And the bros, the football team, went down and just
why do
beat
they hate
the
Catholics
fuck
like
out
that?
Of the KKK. Because all the Catholics were Italian and Irish immigrants.
So they're just like, they think we're mongrels.
It's all part of the eugenics thing. The KKK.
And they're wasps, so they think you're a papist, dude. You're a Catholic. You're a papist.
Yeah.
You follow the
papist. You know what's fucking nuts, dude? I was watching that eugenics stuff, and one of the videos was Glenn Beck, and he like collects all this fucking insane shit, and he's got a girl's KKK costume. Never thinking that the girls are in it.
Dude, I get... Dragons. World War II propaganda. I keep it in my house.
Oh, I gotta
like
show
the
you
posters.
I gotta
show
you these pictures of my grandpa. I'll show it to
but
you.
Now
in,
I got
in
a,
between
a couple posters with swastikas on them in my living room.
Dude, I was just watching the Glenn Beck thing, and so he had to buy that at an auction.
Yeah.
So he bought a KKK costume. He bought a slave dog tag. It's like
Jesus.
Yeah, he's like so they had all the slaves numbered, and you'd had to wear like a little dog tag.
Jesus.
But like he's out at these auctions, like buying this stuff, you know. And he has like his own little museum.
That's a fucking.
Yeah, I want to clarify what I said about the swastikas in my house. They're all it's Soviet propaganda.
It's an Indian.
So it'd be like a wolf with like a sword through its back.
Yeah, right.
But it has a swastika on it.
It's an Indian peaceable.
Yes.
So we're good.
Oh wow! Is it
beautiful? Beautiful.
This is a good podcast. I'm having a lot of fun.
Get your picks. We're already an hour, and then I'll give Shane a little song.
All right.
I'll give you a nice little song that you might like. I don't know. All right, don't do that, dude. Chill.